Good morning, friends, and thank you, Dr. Tejas, for giving me this opportunity. I'm talking about the phakic IOLs. We've been talking about the laser vision correction, and not everyone is a laser vision correction candidate. There are irregular corneas, thin corneas, flat corneas, and scarred corneas where you cannot definitely do laser vision correction. And in these cases, a lens-based procedure comes in handy. I'm not talking about the removal of lens, but I'm talking about phakic IOL or duophakia or artifakia, where there is a lens placed between the cornea and the crystalline lens. It could be fixated in the angle or maybe enclavated to the mid-peripheral iris with a claw or placed in the posterior chamber. And what I'm doing most commonly today is the posterior chamber phakic IOL, which is known as implantable collamer lens. The advantage is that allows the crystalline lens to retain its function, because most of these patients where we are doing it are young. So retention of accommodation is a very important fact. And if we do not have the retention of accommodation, the patient suffers for the near vision. They are extremely predictable, immediately stable became, and the refractive outcome depends very little on the healing process. As soon as you put the lens in, there's a small incision surgery in the range of about 2 to 3 millimeter, and the refractive correction is excellent. The most important fact when I talk about these lenses is their possibility of removal and exchangeability or reversibility. And that is what I tell all my patients, that in case of the smallest possibility or situation where they are causing any issues like uveitis or antisubcapsular cataract or whatever, glaucoma and flattening of antechamber, we can easily remove them very comfortably, and it does not lead to any complications. So that way the reversibility of the procedure is one fantastic plus point about this. And they are easily adjustable with you can fine tune with laser or other procedures. Of course, they carry a risk of an intraocular procedure. There are many types of lenses which are now given up, the angle fixated lenses, and then they caused more uveitis, and also angle supported foldable lenses like Vivate, which now they are not being used. This is my own picture of my patient with the ICL inside the eye, which you can see is having a very nice vault of about 250 to 300 microns. The optical zone diameter, as you see, when you talk about the optical zone of the ICL is small, but the effective optical zone on the plane of the cornea is in the range of about 7 millimeter. So that is fantastic, because you never have these complaints from the patient. Even if the pupil size is 6 millimeter or 6.5 millimeter, the patients do not complain about the glare and halos in the dark. There are three models available. Mostly what we are using is ICL V4B. V4C has just come with a small hole in the center, which is in the size of 360 microns. And we have been using V4 for last about 4.5-5 years. And V4B is a better lens, in the sense that there are fenestrations in the periphery which can take care of the removal of viscoelastic, and also it helps in the overall washout of the OVDs from the AC. The diopter range which is available is 0.5 to 18 diopter spherical in the current scenario, and up to plus 10 spherical, and with the astigmatic correction of up to 6 diopters. This is the and also in the initial powers, it is available in 0.5 diopters, and over higher diopters it is available in 0.25 diopters. The central thickness is 50 microns, and with this is the no touch zone when you are implanting the lens, so that you do not perforate the lens. The thickness of the haptics is 100 microns, and thickness of the edge is about 500 to 600 microns. So the lens is, and it is fantastically vaulted, so it doesn't touch the iris or the crystalline lens. The ideal ICL patients are between 18 to 45 with a corrected visual acuity of about 6 by 18 or better without any previous ophthalmic surgery. The ACD from endothelium should be 2.8 millimeter or more, and that is the most important fact which we should observe, and has to have a stable refraction and without any ocular pathology. Indications for toric ICLs which are available is myopic, hyperopic, mixed and pure astigmatism. Now these lenses are also available in mixed astigmatic correction. They can be used after the keratoplasties, stable keratoconus, form thrust keratoconus, and also undercorrected because of the rings or after cross-linking. And I've done a lot of patients after cross-linking and they give excellent results. The angle and all, despite the fact that you have checked the AC depth, it is very important to see for angle anomalies. There should not be a peripheral plateau kind of iris where there is a possibility of narrow angle, because when the lens sits in the periphery, it can make it further narrowed and a kind of glaucoma which is, you know, which will need glaucoma medication for a long time in a normal eye otherwise. So that we have to check, we have to see what kind of iris anomalies we are, or iris formation we are looking at with the anti-angle. For wide to wide, because the lens sizing is from wide to wide, so it is actually wide to wide and not black to black, black to black. So we have to see with the caliper and confirm it on the scale, steel scale, and that is the best. Though another method which we use normally is pentacam, and there the results are pretty corroborative with each other, but still wide to wide with caliper is a very good idea. Ideally sized IGL has a vault of about 250 to 750 microns. Undersized IGL will touch the anterior capsule and cause opacification, and oversized ICL will push the iris forward and may cause glaucoma. So that is why the sizing of the ICL horizontally is very, very important. And this is my technique of implanting an ICL. I just mark as to where the axis has to be set. It is a case of toric ICL. And I just make a main port, and here you see a main port is made. The pupil is fully dilated by tropicamide and phenylephrine solution, and this is a 3.2 millimeter keratome. And when we are, you know, opening the AC, it is very, very important to be very gentle, because if we are treating, you know, we are dealing with a normal, absolutely normal eye, so we don't want the keratome to go very sharp and, you know, touch the any part of the cornea. Just make the main port of 3.2 millimeter size. The lens is already preloaded, and you can have the preloaded lens, the ICL, for about comfortably for about 2 to 3 minutes. So just load and make the main port, fill the AC with the HPMC, and then push the lens in, and it comes. And there are two types of injectors available, the screw and the push. And here what I am using is a push injector, and it goes inside, and you gently push the ICL into the AC, and it opens very, very gently. It's a collamer, it's a collagen polymer, so it opens very, very gently, and then you can put a little bit of viscoelastic in front of the ICL, and with this lens pusher you can push the haptics behind the iris very gently, align the marks on the ICL, as you can see, just pushing, and then here is the alignment. It is 15 degree up or down maximum on the horizontal axis, so lens always sits in the horizontal axis. And once you have marked the, you know, adjusted the ICL, I'll take another 30 seconds maximum. Just confirm that your access is properly placed. Put a little bit of myocol. Make a side port and put a little bit of myocol. And in this ICL, it is very important to have a small iridotomy. You can do a laser iridotomy initially, but once I did a laser iridotomy and it closed just post-op day one, despite the fact that I had made two iridotomies. And since then, I make a single large iridotomy with the vitrectome, which is slightly more expensive proposal, but it is absolutely wonderful. So with the myocol, you constrict the pupil, and then a vitrectome is taken in, and you can see there's a cut rate of 10 only. So little bit of viscoelastic inside, and I'm using an infinity cut rate of 10. So you put the vacuum, goes to 500, and make a single cut after about 20 seconds, so or maybe 10 seconds, and that makes a wonderful iridotomy. So only one main port, one single side port later, and as you can see, the vacuum will rise and it holds the iris, and then you can see and makes a wonderful small iridotomy, and that is the end of the procedure. You just wash out. Just while washing out, push the BSS in. Do not pull anything out. So just one single cannula goes in. Thank you very much.